Hi, I'm Colin, welcome to Learn Somatics. Today I want to show you a movement called the side bend. This movement's great for releasing the obliques, the QLs, and getting more awareness of the waist muscles, essentially. It's very good if you've got a one-sided hip, knee, or ankle, or shoulder problem as well. So give it a try and see how you get on. Side bend. Working position for the side bend is as so, lying on your side, hips 90 degrees, and then just the knees bent comfortably. You can let your head rest along your arm. Okay, so this is all about contracting and relaxing the side of the body. Everything from here to here, all right? So, I want to show you something. If you lie on your side like this, and if I say to you, press your ribs into the floor, so you're going to press your bottom side rib down into the table. You'll notice what happens. So if I do that, see what happens to my head? My head starts to lift up. And also you'll feel under your, these muscles here in your waist, they tighten, right? Ah, okay. So if I press my ribs down and tighten here, I can lift my head. Up it pops. And it's no strain on the neck when I do it like this, because I'm using my trunk to lift the head. Okay, and then we can come down nice and slowly. So the pressing the ribs down is just a nice, easy way to help you feel, if I use my waist, if I use my trunk, I can lift my head in this position. Okay, so I'm going to put the hand up over the head now. And that palm of the hand is on the top of the head. Don't have the hand back, top of the head, fingers just above the ears, okay? And we'll do the same thing again. Now I'm going to press my ribs down so that my waist tightens on the top side. My top side waist is going to tighten when I press my ribs down. Okay, so now I'm up in the air, I'm moving, I can carry on like that by using my waist muscles more strongly. Okay, from here, what do I want to do? I want to release deliberately, so I'm just going to come down nice and slow. And I'm going to try and lengthen my waist as long as I can as I come down. Okay. Good. And again, pressing the ribs down makes the head light, engages the waist so I can lift my head. And coming down nice and slowly. Really take your time with this one. These side muscles they can be a little more difficult to sense because we don't often do side bending in normal everyday life, unfortunately. And again, pressing the ribs down, using the waist muscles to pick up the head. You can use a little bit of effort with the arm to help you, and that just gets into some of the muscles into the shoulder a bit as well. And when you're coming down, just let everything relax. Nice and easy. And to complete rest. Breathing wise, you can do this on either variation. You can either inhale up, exhale down, or exhale up and inhale down. It doesn't really matter. And if you're not sure, just breathe normally. Okay. So we're starting to get the hang of side bending the top half, bringing the upper body up off the table, and then slowly releasing. Great. Now, what happens with the bottom half? Similar story. We're going to use the sides of our body. If you press your ribs down again, you'll feel not only does your head pick up a little bit, but your watch what happens in my ribs, or sorry, in my hip, just moves this way a little bit. So you exaggerate that, do it more, and then you can start to lift the foot up as well. And again, you'll feel a strong contraction here in the waist. You'll see the creases in my t-shirt, that shows you what's happening. And then let that relax so that the hip can move away and the foot can come down. So you can even put your hand here on the side of your hip, and as you tighten your waist, roll, the hip can roll this direction towards the armpit. If you're feeling discomfort in your groin or in your outside of your hip when you do this, it's because you are not using your waist. Okay, so take your time, put your hand in the soft part here, and make sure that you can feel these muscles contracting to draw the hip to the armpit, and that allows the foot to come up easier. Again, you'll notice you should be seeing some creases appearing in your shirt, and then come down nice and slow. Okay, let's put the two things together. So we're gonna put the arm back over the head, and we're gonna do the lower half and the top half together to make it a full body movement, a full side bend. So nice and easy. Head comes up, hip comes to armpit, ribs go down, tight here in the waist, and we can feel the whole side of the body contract very clearly. And then we're just gonna come down nice and slow. And you can make adjustments as you come on your way down to release where you need to release. Let's inhale up, exhale down. And if you want to try the opposite breath, let's exhale up and inhale down. If the breathing is confusing you, or are you finding it difficult to time, just breathe normally and do the movement. It's no problem. Side bending. I'm using my right side to lift my head, to lift my arm, and to lift my hip and my foot. And then slowly letting the whole waist get long as I come down. Okay. Once you've done the full movement 3 or 4 times, that's plenty. You can lay out flat and check in, see how that feels. Compare the feeling down the right side to the left side. What's different? You should feel a marked difference between your left, basically the sort of feeling of length from your armpit on the right, down your side, down into your leg, compared to the left. Notice what that feels like, and then once you're ready, change sides, play the video back, and you can even yourself up by repeating that sequence on the second side. And that's the side bend.